What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to add mods to your ARK Survival Evolved Apex server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Like most popular sandbox survival games, ARK Survival Evolved has an active and growing modding community. There are thousands of mods available for you to choose from that can improve vanilla gameplay or change it so drastically that it might as well be a different game. Adding mods to a server can be a bit more complicated than adding them to a game on Steam, so let's get you prepared. The quickest and easiest way to find the mods that you want is to look them up in the Steam Workshop. You can get to the workshop by selecting the game in Steam, then clicking on the Workshop tab in the game's profile page. Once you're in the workshop, you'll be able to browse through all of the mods available for your game. Once you find a mod you like, click on it, and then click on the green subscribe button, which will start to immediately download and install the mod. Once the mods have finished downloading, start up the game to verify that they have been installed and activated. Once the game is open and running, you should see a notification in the bottom right saying that the mods are being installed. Once this is done, start a host local game and find your mods in the available mods section. Select your mod and then use the arrow button to activate them. Once you have verified that the mods are up and running on your game, you can add them to your server. First, you're going to need to find the mod files on your computer. Open Steam and right-click on ARK Survival Evolved. Choose the Manage option and then browse local files. This will open up the game files in a new window. From here, you can head to Shooter Game, Content, and then Mods. And once you're in the Mods folder, you'll find a mod file and then a folder with a lot of numbers. This is the mod ID and it will be needed later, so make a note or keep this file nearby. Next, head over to your server's control panel and press the red stop button. And then click on FTP file access and log in. Head to the mods folder on your server the same way you did on your computer, so you'll want to head to Shooter Game, Content, and then Mods. Click on the Upload tab on the left-hand side, and then on the next page, be sure to upload both the mod folders and the mod files to your server. After you finish uploading the mods, you'll have to configure the server. This is the most difficult part of the process, so let's go over how to do it. Go back to FTP file access and open the Shooter Game folder, and then open the Saved folder, Config, and finally Linux Server. Find the file called Game User Settings and click Edit to the right-hand side to open the web editor. At the bottom of the Server Settings section, add Active Mods equals sign. After the equal sign, paste the mod ID that you made a note of earlier. To add more mods, all you're going to have to do is add a comma and then each mod ID after that. Once you're done, press the green save button at the top of the page, and then you can head back to the server to start loading up the mods. If you're getting a mod mismatch error when you try to join, one of your mods probably received an update. Steam will automatically download any updates to your mods, but you'll need to re-upload the latest version to your server. If the issue persists, go to your mods folder on your computer and delete it. A new one will be generated, and the latest version of the mod will be installed by Steam when you try to join the server again. If your mods aren't loading on the server at all, make sure you added all of the mod files to your server and not just the folder or the mod file itself. You'll also need to make sure you're adding the mods to the game user settings file. If your files are too big, you also have the option to zip the file before you upload it onto the FTP panel. After that's uploaded, you can return back into the FTP, select the file, and press unzip in the top right corner to finish the installation. Adding mods to your ARK server can drastically enhance gameplay for you and your players, and with so many different options to choose from, you can always find something different to try out. So make sure to experiment and find out which ones work best for you.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.